Well, today on Top Garage, we look at my new Duramax. Well, guys, after a long break on YouTube, I've officially returned, and I've returned with the Duramax. My first ever Duramax, actually second, but my first 17 to 19 Duramax. My game plan was to secure a 17 to 19 Duramax, the last year for the true Allison. I wanted to secure one under 100,000 miles as cheaply as possible. And it already has problems. Buy a Duramax and it's got problems. So today we're gonna attempt, I don't know, maybe to fix one of the issues. There's water in the fuel notification on the dash. I don't know when the last time the fuel filter was changed, but let's talk about a couple details on the rig here. So this is a 2018 Chevy 2500 6.6 Duramax, brother. Allison, brother. And yes, it has a water in the fuel notification, so something's going on there. So this truck I actually did purchase under 100,000 miles. It was just under 100 at like 99. It is now over 100. It's like at 101 or something because I've been driving it. Yeah, I've been driving it. And I got it for like 38 grand. Now, you guys be the judge. I don't normally say what I purchase vehicles for on the channel, but who cares? Here it is. What do you think? Good price, bad price? I don't know. It's an LTZ. And it had these two-piece fuel Maverick, I don't even know what they are, fuel wheels, two-piece. So the center bolts to the barrel. I know that's a little bit higher end than the traditional fuels, so at least we got that. Probably the cheapest mud tires you can get, Iron Man All Country MTs. They're a little loud on the highway and I got a little shimmy at 75. So let's take a look under the hood, see what kind of action we're working with. Well, that is a Duramax. We got a big thing coming over here. A big box right here says Duramax 6.6 HD, brother. And it's dirty. It's a little dirty. Looking at, do you see that hair? Look at that hair flying out of there. I've been carrying my dog around in here and oh my, is there a lot of hair in the thing. So the hair is from me. The hair, I didn't buy the truck with the hair. Hair wasn't included. It smells clean. I'm real big on a vehicle smelling nice. It smells good. It wasn't some crap stain, crotch stink in there, you know, it's good. I threw some WeatherTex in here. I got the, whatever those were, you know, the WeatherTex that were, you know, laser lined. They're in there. I put them in. There was no mats. So this was at the auction. We got this at the auction. And, you know, sometimes people go auction shopping, like other dealers. Someone took the mats, or they took them when they traded in. I don't know. Whew. So it's a borderline colossal mess. It was dirty before I did this to it. So, you know, just relax. I got a couple new little detailing tools. We got this Vortex here, but it's black leather. You know, the seats aren't in terrible shape. The truck, you know, lived 100,000 mile life before I got a hold of it. So, you know, there's going to be some wear. No center console, which I wasn't set on no center console. Everything I've always had a center. But honestly, it's not that bad. It's kind of convenient when you got to put a bunch of junk in here. You can just set down here, you know. But the interior needs a heavy detail even before the dog hair was added. Here we go. TP1015. Got a new fuel filter. We're going to drop that fuel filter housing, or at least the bottom off of it. Then we're going to swap the fuel filter in hopes to fix the water and the fuel situation. But, you know, these things could, it could be a bad sensor. There could be water. One of two things. Probably water. Oh! Another quick little 2-cent thing. Since we're coming back, we're just going to keep this video all over the place. What I've been running in all my diesels, so power stroke, still got the power stroke, the 11 single, or the 12 single cab red F-350, epic, sweet truck. I got the Cummins, so now we officially own all three, Duramax, power stroke, Cummins. I've been running Marvel Mystery. I was running everyday treatment through Hotshot Secret in all the trucks, every truck I've ever had. But I've been running Marvel Mystery in like my dirt bikes and small engines and lawnmowers and stuff forever. So I figured, you know, I'll do a swap. I'll do a long-term swap and run the Marvel Mystery in the tank with each fuel fill up. But I'm excited to use this. Driver's side, we got a small rip in the seat. Maybe we'll get the interior guy to butter that up. You ever seen an interior guy work? They do work. They work magic. I don't really care about the rip in the seat. I mean, for 38 grand, what do you expect? In today's market, prices are actually coming down. I've been dealing a lot with buying and selling vehicles over my break from YouTube, which I should have been filming all that. Would have been made great content. But yeah, market's coming down. My biggest thing about the truck is the steering wheel. There's wear in the center of the steering wheel. Whoever was driving this thing had that grip, man, that grip on that steering wheel, you know? So right in the top center of the steering wheel, it's wore. I think you can get a new one from GM for like $169, which I might do because I don't like that. Other than that, it's great. All right, so we're gonna get covered by the nectar of the gods here. This is fairly straightforward. Gotta get a 36, get it on there. Oh, baby, that ain't good. It's starting to strip. Ooh, feels a little butchered, you know? What do you think? I don't wanna strip that. That would be very not cool. Oh no, it's gone. Dude, I'll tell you what. That slips off, you take a knuckle bust right onto this here. Whoo, you'll be hurting. You will be in pain. I don't know what that was. Now there is gonna be a little bit of fuel coming out of this. Try to not have it run all over me. There it is. There she goes. Oh, baby. Oh, God. I'd say we were due. I'm gonna meet you on the bench. The whole process, but you know, at first glance, I haven't touched this. I came straight over here. Dude, there is some nasty on top of this filter. And look at the whole filter. Jeez, dude. It is bad. What is that? That is rust. That ain't good. Oh, yeah. It's stuck. Ooh! Okay. I mean, that has me slightly concerned. That is sludge. The filter is very, very sludged. It's a little metallic-y in there. Definitely water. Look at that bubble. Right there, see all that? That would be water. All right, I got the little O-ring off the nipple in the fuel filter housing on the truck. And it feels like this thing is like Play-Doh. It's very, very soft. And it feels like it was literally about to just disintegrate. So, I know a lot of guys don't even know that's there. Make sure you change that. They give you a new one with the new filter. I'll show you on the truck. There's a little nipple that comes down to the fuel filter housing and it goes right on the end, just the tip. All right, get down here. I threw my back out running a jackhammer the other day, so it's fun. Under here, sorry for the shaky camera. I know I've been doing this long enough. I know that a shaky camera is no good. This little nipple coming out of the fuel filter housing. New O-ring goes right on the end. You'll see this little groove right here. Boom, O-ring goes right in there. Standard procedure for a fuel filter replacement. Cycle the key. We had the whole housing drained. It's doing some stuff. I hear some stuff floating around. You hear that? Oh yeah. For how easy the Duramax fuel filter is, there ain't no reason you guys should be skipping that. No reason. If this was a CP4 truck, it would probably be no more. Probably wouldn't be happy. And listen, the more cycles, the better. How many cycles? I don't know. Give it a couple. Cycle the key. Just do it. It's like, oh, we got fuel. I think we're all right. I think it went away. I think that's pretty good. So, numero uno solved, fuel filter change. Very simple. Numero dos, I got the coolant level low issue. Standard L5P procedure. The coolant level sensor is molded into the coolant tank and the sensors go bad. So to replace the sensor, you gotta get a new tank. The temp stays perfect. We're great on temperature. So, and what's actually crazy is that bottle looks new. See how it's real white? Bottle's nice and bright, white and clean. It's not like old yeller. So maybe someone replaced the bottle and the sensor's still bad. Let's see if it came on. Nope, not on. But we'll figure that out. I'll take you guys along the ride, see what we got to do. I got a couple things up my sleeve. Guys, Duramax parts are being added to the website. Shop Modern Diesel, shameless plug. Website's going to be loaded up with Duramax stuff. For detailing, you know, that you can get kind of crazy with detailing. I just wanted to share, you know, what I do when I detail a vehicle. So to me, a detailed vehicle is just clean. You know, it ain't loaded up with some shine or some armor all gunk or whatever. It's just a clean, stripped of dirt, grime, slime, all of it, just clean. So what I found that does that pretty easily is the Griot's interior detailer. You know, completely not affiliated. I buy this stuff just straight retail. They actually sell it in advance. You can order it on Amazon, whatever. So you spray that up, you know, get a little detail brush. You can also, I get these on Amazon, couple bucks, and you get it whipping, you know, you get it ripping, you get a little suds action going on. Then you just take a microfiber, wipe it off, and then you hit it with the air. Also Amazon, cheap. So as you can see here, it's just a clean vehicle. It's just clean. There's everything, all the dirt and grease from your hands on the steering wheel, stuff on the seats. Everything's just stripped of dirt and it's just clean. Now the leather is stripped, so it is, you know, you probably could put some protectant on the leather, which I sometimes do. If I get a little carried away, I'll use this over here, this Coverall interior dressing. I don't go crazy with this stuff. It's just a quick spray. Just to put something on there, it gives it a tiny bit of shine. Like I'll put this maybe up on the dash, something like that. You know, light sprays, even it out, wipe it off, and it works pretty good. You know, that resembles, you know, if you're going to go to like a professional, get a professional detail done, that's what it should look like. So there you go. We got the Duramax. We officially got one. So probably going to keep this one. So what always ends up happening is I get these trucks and someone comes by and buys them. Someone comes through and buys them. So this one here, though, I don't think I'm going to make this one available to buy, to sell, I mean. We're going to hold on to that one. It's a pretty good truck, minus all the Duramax issues. Coolant level sensor's bad, and we fixed the water. That freaking fuel filter was absolutely hammered.